Good morning, dear students. Welcome in social science class. Dear students, as we all know that chapter 4 we have started, that is called sensitivity towards others. Sensitivity means feeling of love, care and support towards others. We have already started this chapter. I've shared one video related to the gist of the chapter, what exactly is there. So today we are going to start a chapter with the reading section. So without wasting time, we can start. In class 4th, you read about caring for older members of the family. That maybe chapter was there with you related to the special children's. You know that visually impaired mean those who are not able to see properly, and hearing impaired, those who are not able to hear properly, are called special children. Now let us read how a little care and love can make a great difference in the lives of physically challenged and socially deprived children. Physically challenged, those who are not able to walk properly, they are having some disability in their body. And socially deprived children who are not getting proper rights, respect, dignity in the society. So with this beginning, we can start with physically challenged children. Here is a case study of a girl who her name is Saloni. She is suffering from cerebral palsy. It is a kind of disease in which a person's body cannot move properly and cannot respond properly. So we can discuss what exactly is there. Young Saloni suffers from cerebral palsy. It is the condition where a person's muscles do not respond. Look at the picture also, how her arms and legs are looks like. Her right side is weaker than the left. Right side responding little less as compared to the left side. Her right arm is rigid. Rigid means cannot work. And she has a brace for the right leg. Brace means extra support for walking. Right leg, and she walks in a bumpy way. Bumpy way means in a jerk, in a jumping manner or having with jerk. She cannot run and her speech is unclear. Even whenever she is speaking something, that is also not clear. She finds it difficult to hold a pencil and write, not able to write properly because her muscles are not that much strong. She has to undergo speech and occupational therapy. It means she needs some trainers, some doctors, therapists who can look after her in a proper manner. She remains quiet and does not interact with other children because she feels that she cannot look like other children. The only time she smiles when her teacher switches on the music. Her body sways. Sways means started dancing in a rhythmic manner, rhythm of the music. So this was the story of Saloni, who is suffering from cerebral palsy. Next we have here, in earlier times, most physically challenged children were not given any special education and training. Yes, it was there. They were always remain in their houses. The parents were unaware about the help and training that could make their life happy and comfortable. Earlier people were not aware, they were not having such kind of education awareness about the special children. But nowadays parents are aware if such kind of child are there, children are there, kids are there, they can be supported by the different therapists or the trainers. But in recent times, a lot of progress has been made in this field. Now, many specially trained teachers and therapists provide guidance to the special children. Their families are also trained to deal with them. Progress in the field of science and technology have made the physically challenged children more mobile and independent. Yes, they are very far away now. They can give each and every support to each and every children. They can use special machines for exercise and greater movement. Yes, they can provide, if the hearing impairment is there, then hearing aid is there, walking problem is there, then braces are there, each and everything they are providing to their kids. So we will do today this much only. You can read up to here. Rest topics we will cover up in the live classes. One, do you know, is also here. The physically challenged children need adaptive devices. Adaptive devices means extra devices who can support them in their daily chores. And therapeutic devices also can help them to their extra activities for the mobility as well as for the other activities like sitting, eating and use of toilet independently instead of taking help of others. So this was all about today. You can read chapter up to here and then we will discuss next in a live class. Thank you.